some of the most powerful lightning events can propagate horizontally for tens of kilometers and connect to the ground with a massive surge of electricity. We call these horizontally extensive ground flashes. Seeing these big daddies blossom underneath storm clouds is a jaw-dropping sight. But underneath the storm, you're still only seeing half the show. If a ground flash is powerful enough, it can flip the charge at the top of thunderstorms, initiating another spectacular light show high above the storm. These red sprites belong to a group of mysterious, large-scale electrical discharges.
Ooh, nice.
Called Transient Luminous Events, or TLEs. In order to see the spectacular parent lightning discharges in all their glory,
oh, holy moly!
And the TLEs they initiate above the storm,
whoa!
We're gonna need to be in two places at one time. In this video, I team up with storm chaser Paul Smith to simultaneously document the most powerful lightning flashes and the magnificent TLEs they parent in what we call the over-under experiment.
Good to hear from you.
Yeah, you too.
So what do you say tonight we try the over-under thingy?
That sounds like a plan.
I got a good feeling about it.
Awesome, man. Yeah, me too. I think we'll be onto something. Man, it's so beautiful here. There's not a cloud in the sky. Not one.
Got a can of off if you need it. No? You're hardcore.
These are negative ground flashes, the most common manifestation of cloud-to-ground lightning. But these rarely transfer enough charge to spark a TLE. For this experiment to be successful, I'm going to have to locate a rain-free vicinity of the storm where the horizontally extensive positive ground flashes are occurring.
It's dark already, and I have a feeling that over my shoulder, there could be sprites firing already. I'm still 50 miles out. The good thing about it is when I get there, the sky should be fairly dark, but I think it's probably too bright to be shooting sprites in that direction anyway right now. I'm not missing out too bad, I don't think.
While the lightning is wrapped in rain and you can't see a whole lot of it right now anyway, but maybe we'll be able to eke out some of the lightning that'll be visible, and maybe Paul can capture some sprites up above. He's pretty consistent on catching the sprites, but you never know. We're gonna take what the storm gives us. It only takes one good one to make the night successful.
Whenever I shoot in that area, I get the police called on me generally. There's a lot of truckers go by there, and I guess if they see somebody in the ditch, are looking suspicious around all the oil and gas stuff, maybe they call the cops. So I just called ahead and let them know. I've talked with police, the sheriffs from there before, and they said that's the best thing to do, just give us a call ahead of time and let us know you're going to be there, and then we know not to come out if there's a call. So hopefully we don't see any red and blue flashing lights in my shots tonight. Fun.
Paul had forecast a great location with a clear view over the thunderstorm complex. After a couple hours struggling under the storm, I was beginning to see perfect conditions to capture the most powerful lightning strikes 20 or so miles ahead.
If I get sprites now, they're going to be right at the top of the clouds.
All right, it's time. It's about to happen.
We're two guys 150 miles apart trying to figure out a 40 millisecond flash 50 miles above the ground.
We're due for another big flash here.
Right.
I'm going to roll some video. Oop, flash, big flash, and CG.
Oh my gosh! Yes!
Awesome! Got it, 240 frames per second.
Roll some
Big flash.
Oh my gosh! I'm gonna go set up, put the other camera at a tighter crop.
Yep, go for it. I'll scream if I see something. We'll check the footage later.
Yeah, I'll sit you down next to my reporter here.
Boom! Holy moly!
Yes, sir!
Notice in this match how the sprite isn't initiated until the lightning connects to the ground.
Yeah, I'll sit you down next to my reporter here.
Boom! Holy moly!
Yes, sir!
I'll scream if I see something. We'll check the footage later.
Yeah, I'll sit you down next to my reporter here.
Hey!
My ISO is too high. I gotta put my ISO down.
Oh, I got somebody driving up on me in the middle of nowhere.
Oh, don't you love that?
It could be.
That's how every horror film. Boom!
Whoa!
Boom!
Yes!
That's how every horror film. Boom!
Whoa!
Yes! Yeah, dude, that was a gooder. That was a real gooder.
Wow, you should see it on my end.
Hey there. I'm just taking pictures. Yes, sir.